Global Champions League is the world's most prestigious team competition in show jumping. Top riders join forces to form elite multinational teams competing for the sport's highest prize money.
Each team is required to have one under 25 rider.
On the angle.
Oh, what a ride!
Some of these under 25 riders will be the champions of tomorrow.
Oh, he ducks out.
It puts me on a new stage that I haven't been on before.
Be as good as we can and compete with the people at the higher level.
Yeah, you want to do it right for the team.
Two out of two. She has not made it. She won it. She wins it. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Prague.
I'm here to win and not just take part.
In 2006, Olympic medalist Jan Tops founded the Longines Global Champions Tour. The vision was to pit the world's top 30 jumpers against each other in an electrifying series of shows. The tour's thrilling challenges and iconic locations soon made it the ultimate individual show jumping circuit, where only the best make the grade. And in 2016, Global Champions added a team league, in which the top riders from different nations join forces.
Global Champions League is a team format where six riders come together regardless of their nationality. They've got one under 25 rider and five plus 25 riders, and that's pretty unique.
We believe that, you know, to have young riders getting the experience on the highest level, for them it's a life learning curve, and that's why all the teams are obliged to give the experience to be that you have a rider under 25 in that team.
Being part of the Global Champions League is, yeah, it's a great opportunity to do these shows, and especially when you have the horses for it, you have a great chance to get into this level.
You're competing against top of the world, the best riders, best horses. It's already amazing. A lot of people are watching the Global Champions League, so has a big impact for my career.
So it's it basically gives me that platform to try and produce my career and get as good as I can and gain all the experience.
Dream come true for me to be here.
In this series, we follow some of the league's most promising young riders, hungry to prove they've got what it takes to be a global champion. Will they rise to the challenge?
You want to be the best rider you can be. I want to try and keep the family name going, obviously, as well, but obviously create my own kind of brand, I guess, in the sport. I want to be the best rider. I want to be the best rider I can be, and hopefully that's the best rider in the world at some point.
The Whittakers are one of the most successful dynasties in equestrian. Michael and John are legends in the sport, but all eyes are now on Jack, the youngest of the clan.
Yeah, no, when you have the Whittaker name, people think there's a lot of pressure behind it, but there's none at all, you know. It's fantastic. I couldn't have asked for a better upbringing around horses than the family we had. We must nearly have 100 horses on the farm at home. From foals to retirees that my father was winning Grand Prix on, so as an influencer, you couldn't say anybody else. I wouldn't be here without him at all, you know.
There was no other option for Jack Whittaker than to become a show jumper. With his father being so successful, his uncle, his nephews, his nieces, siblings, the whole family is so deeply embedded in the sport that there was no other option. If he would not compete, I think he would have been kicked out of the family.
I had a much bigger advantage than a lot of other young riders would have had in their time, and I understand that. I'm just trying to take as much advantage of that as possible.
For the 2022 championship season, Jack was invited to join the Madrid In Motion team.
We knew the owner of the team, the manager of the team before anyway, and he's a good family friend of ours, and I think they needed an under 25 rider, and I guess they thought of me.
Well, he's one of the most talented young riders from now, and okay, with the surname he has, Whittakers, for sure he's gonna keep on the legend alive for a long time.
I'm not trying to prove myself to anybody, but more, I just want to make sure I keep winning, and I deserve to be there, you know. For someone like me to be a part of the Madrid In Motion team, it's a great opportunity to try and further my career, gain as much experience as possible. I won't be able to get into these shows otherwise.
Obviously, you want to compete with the team as much as possible and try and hopefully get the team higher up in the rankings.
Another young rider getting attention is Ireland's Michael Pender, who's earned his place in the sport thanks to hard work and very supportive horse owners.
How I started working at HHS was Ryan asked me to ride a pony, and it started from there, and then I'm still here 6 years later working with them. I've been very, very lucky. They've given me the best opportunities and some fantastic horses to ride, so I'm very, very grateful to them.
I've been breeding horses all my life. My father loved horses, so he built a team of horses back in 30 years ago, and I've been lucky enough to be able to continue it and to compete at this high level with Mikey. It's a dream for us.
If you look at Michael Pender's story, for some might have been a surprise. He wasn't the big name, he wasn't a big Grand Prix winner like some other under 25 riders. The horses grow with him, his talent grows, his contribution to Saint-Tropez Pirate grows. So it's a great story of how you can really earn your place in Global Champions League. And if you perform, this is the springboard for your career. So it was really good sourcing to bring Michael Pender into the Saint-Tropez Pirates team. And though he was a surprise to many, he straight away found his groove, he straight away found his rhythm.
This season, I want to jump as many clear rounds as I can for the Saint-Tropez Pirates and the GCL leagues. I think I have a fantastic group of horses that can really help with it.
Hello and welcome to the 2022 Global Champions League season. It kicks off right here in Doha, Qatar, on the Arabic Peninsula.
Each stage of the Longines Global Champions Tour involves two rounds of jumping in the team league. Riders jump against the clock and receive penalty points for knocking down fences or exceeding the time allowed. For each round, two riders are picked to represent their teams. And in this first stage in Doha, both Jack and Michael get that chance. Jack and Michael both jump clear in the first round, with one fence down in the second. But in the end, Jack's team is fastest, earning third place on the podium.
It was a great way to kick it all off with the new team in the new year. That's why I was a little bit disappointed with the one down. It's a great feeling. It was my first podium with the team. It was only the first show, but you also want to be on top of the podium.
I rode Kelly. I was clear the first day on the team, and I had one down the second day, my mistake. The horse jumped very good. We were a little bit unlucky with the team, but the horses were in good form, and hopefully we can do a bit better.
In the heat of Miami Beach, the championship continues, with new young riders joining the tour.
Hi, I'm Sanne Thijssen. I'm 23 years old. I'm from the Netherlands. I'm the under-25 rider of Istanbul Sultans in the Global Champions League.
Sanne Thijssen hit the spotlight last year in an amazing jump-off with 2021's world number one rider, Daniel Deusser.
46.28 seconds. Unbelievable! Unbelievable from Sanne Thijssen.
Yeah, Valkenswaard was a really tough show. That was the only global I could ride last year. Yeah, what I said, it was in Holland, so I got a spot there.
The Longines Global Champions Tour features the world's top show jumpers. But at each location, the best national riders like Sanne are also invited to compete.
And Conquidam was in a great shape, and then I had to jump off with Daniel winning it. Being second next to such a great big rider is a good feeling. Of course, you always want to win.
I think Istanbul Sultans picked Sanne Thijssen for several reasons. It's a new team with riders that haven't always featured at the level, so they needed a little bit of experience, which is bizarre if you think about it, that you go to an under 25 rider for experience, but she already had some experience at five-star level, but it's that performance in Valkenswaard that really put her in the spotlight, I think.
This season, as part of the Istanbul Sultans team, Sanne can compete in all global champion shows. Could this be the year she wins her first LGCT Grand Prix?
She's amazing. She's a fierce competitor. She has a great connection with her horses. You can really see the horses love their job and they always do their best for her. And when she's in the ring, she's tough to beat.
I start riding on a young age, of course, on ponies. At that moment, you don't really realize that your father is riding on the big level because, yeah, you're a kid. I mean, when you start on the really small ponies, yeah. the ride is fun. Yeah, you think, yeah, he's horse riding. I'm also horse riding. Yeah. When I started by the horses, I started to do internationals. Yeah, and then you win a bit, and then you get motivated, and yeah, every time you get higher, you get that feeling, and then you realize that you want more, and that you want to go higher and bigger.
Hello and welcome to Miami Beach Global Champions League. It is the second round of the season's second stage here on South Beach in the state of Florida, the Sunshine State.
Miami is quite hot. Actually, we had in Holland, I think 1 week or 2 weeks ago, snowing. So from snow to this weather, it's really intense, yeah.
It's an amazing show here in Miami, to have a show so close to the beach. I think it's the only show in the world like this.
In each round, teams pick two riders and horses to compete, and it comes down to which ones are in the best shape to face the challenge.
What I love about riding is it's an animal. Like, it's not like a car. When it's broken, you bring it to the garage and it's fixed. No. If a horse doesn't feel right, you cannot say, hey, come, today you have to do your job right. You have to feel how they are and how you can make a horse happy.
I believe it's a fantastic sport to be working with an animal, not just relying on yourself. It's with horses, somebody is good one day and someone is unlucky and it's not their day, and there's always another day.
In Miami, Jack's horse needed a rest.
Every horse is different. She's a bit sharp and she sees everything, she hears everything, so I thought it was better for us if I could have a few easy rounds.
That's Daniel Deusser warming up on Killer Queen. This is Michael Pender. Michael on HHS Calais.
It's always a fantastic feeling when you get told you're on the team and to represent the Saint-Tropez Pirates. Today we're riding with Daniel Deusser, one of the best in the world, so hopefully we'll have a good result today.
The first round in Miami didn't go so well for Sana and Konkidam, with three fences down.
Well, that was a bit disappointing. The whole season he never had three down, and today we have three down. Shit happens. Well, that's a sport, huh? But you do want to do it right for the team.
It was a better day for Michael, who jumped clear for the team with his Irish superstar, Calais.
Yeah, I'm absolutely delighted. It's fantastic to jump a clear round for the Saint-Tropez Pirates. I'm absolutely delighted.
Michael Pender is a very young rider in our team, but you don't really realize or you don't really feel it with him. He's very experienced already. Actually, he performed much better than me today. He jumped a clear round. I had four faults afterwards. Yeah, I hope I can do it better than on Saturday.
In round two, the pressure's now on for Michael to deliver a double clear for the team.
Show jumping is down to the finest details, the smallest of margins.
And here's that difficult triple, and Ken, no, he can't.
They're disappointed at one down, but the horse jumped very good, and I'm absolutely delighted with how he jumped, and it's a very, very difficult course, and it's so hot today. At the moment, it's hard to know what place we're going to get with the team, and we're a bit unlucky today.
While Michael may have ended on a bit of a downer in Miami, a rising star from Belgium caught everyone's eye when he placed third in the LGCT Grand Prix. After this amazing individual performance, under 25 rider Jill Thomas was picked for his team, Vulcansvoort United, at the next stage.
Welcome to Mexico City for the third launching Global Champions 2 Grand Prix of the 2022 season. Welcome at the Campo Marte, the battlefield.
To be part of the Vulcansvoort United is a real privilege. I was born in a horse family. My uncle, Mark van Dijk, I was always riding at the highest level for Belgium. I started riding horses quite soon, I think at age of 12 or 13. I think almost every year I won a medal on the Belgian championships, on the European championships. And I think it's also one of the reasons that I'm now in Vulcansvoort United. First time I rode for Vulcansvoort United in the team was in Hamburg, together with Marco Zening. we ended up straight away on the podium. So that was something fantastic. Come home and the people say, oh, hey, you were standing next to Marcus Ennio on the podium. You realize that? I say, yeah, that was me. But actually, when they ask some journalists, who is your all-time idol or who is your favorite rider, I will always say Marcus Ennio.
Yeah, I think he's a very quiet person. He's very focused. He can really feel in his horses how he has to ride them. And he's always a positive guy that we really like.
Last year we won, it was amazing. But you have to realize we are with 16 teams. They all want to win. It's not that you have every year the chance to ride in such a team. So I have to work hard for it and keep the results going on.
Gil is a record-breaking four-time Belgian champion. But will he keep bringing the titles home now he's in the big leagues?
Here comes Gil Thomas, talented Belgian. Here's Thomas, Luna, clear.
They were super strong and I don't think they wanted to risk bringing in Gil Thomas when they had Eening, when they had Fredriksson, when they had Edwina Tops Alexander. Now the season for Valkenswaard United is completely different. Gil Thomas is 1 year older, his horses are 1 year older, and all of a sudden you see that he's becoming, I'm not going to call him the cornerstone of the team, but he's really contributing. If his, the stats prove it, I mean, he produced the lowest average score of the entire team. The team has developed a confidence in Gil Thomas, and Gil Thomas has also developed confidence in himself.
Here's Gil Thomas on his season debut for the team. Is he going to produce the first clear for the team? In 10 rounds, here's Thomas, Luna, clear. That helps them, that helps Valkenswaard United, that throws them a lifeline.
Gil jumps clear in the first round in Mexico City, picking up 4 penalties in the second round, with his team finishing in 5th place overall. Meanwhile, Michael Pender, fueled by his disappointment in Miami, turns it all around.
Pender, who has produced a first round clear at every stage in Doha, in Miami, and now also in Mexico. And Michael Pender is the second man this weekend to jump a double clear over both rounds.
Michael finally makes it to the podium, helping the Saint-Tropez Pirates to second place.
I mean, Mikey is a star. I mean, he's a genius. I knew he was going to make it to this level. And he is a young rider, but he's an old head on young shoulders.
Meanwhile, Jack Whittaker is in trouble.
Yeah, I was just fucking in the stables there and walking past the horse and it just jumped up and kicked out and got me right, like, kicked me in the back, but, like, just left of my spine. But it, like, ruptured my spleen, stopped bleeding inside again, then I have to operate and probably take it out.
While Jack doesn't know how long his spleen injury will keep him out of action this season, Sanna and Gil get another chance to stand out when the championship comes back to Europe in vibrant Madrid. Even when they're not riding for their Global Champions League team, being a part of these world-class events lets these young stars shine.
Today, I'm not part of the team. I'm a star as individual. Every show, you can send 3 riders to a stage and only 2 ride for the team.
In Madrid, the Global Champions riders can also enter the Copa del Rey, a 5-star class and a huge deal here in Spain.
But actually, I like the pressure. When there's some pressure, it keeps me more concentrated. And anyway, I have to ride, if I'm not riding for the team, I ride individual and I have to ride also good. Gives also always a little bit more pressure, but I like it.
And here comes Kaleriama, also flat out, has to check once, 41.06. De Vos or Thomas, De Vos or Thomas, by a second it is Gil Thomas who takes the lead. The lead goes from hand to hand, from Schweitzer to Swollen to De Vos to Thomas.
The pressure brings results, as Gil triumphs and wins the Copa del Rey in an insane jump-off. Meanwhile, Sanna makes it to her first LGCT Grand Prix jump-off this season, and she's hungry for success.
Yes, I'm really competitive. I think it's normal on this level, right? I mean, you're not riding this level just for fun. I mean, a really top sporter rides to win, of course. I think I'm also in like jump offs. I'm that person who really take risks and not trying to be fifth, just trying to be first.
Always, Sun is very thankful and very appreciative of what I'm doing. So it makes you want to work even harder for the results. I never actually work for somebody who works so hard.
I think this is like the most thing we all respect about her, that she's so hardworking. And if you see her in the ring and she's doing well, it gives you even more like a great feeling that she's doing so well because she works so hard.
What is so interesting about Sanna Thaysen is that she, off her horse, she's super insecure. Once she gets on a horse, she's a different person.
If you don't have a horse, you cannot jump the course yourself, huh? Yeah, Konkidam is really special to me. I think he's a once-in-a-lifetime horse. I think it's also really the combination we are together, because I know him already from when he was 7 and he's 16 now. So we know each other for a really long time.
All that she thinks about is how to keep Konkidam happy. And if she can keep him happy, if she can keep that sparkle between the two of them, he'll jump through fire for her.
I really want to win a global Grand Prix, and now I have the opportunity, and now I want to take this chance.
She wants to win that trophy. She wants to win this title here in Madrid. Here comes Sanna Thaysen. She hasn't won a launching Global Champions 2 Grand Prix yet. She was second in Valkenswaard and now risking it all on this super fast horse, this superstar, Konkidam, and Sanna Thaysen for 39-1. She has not won it. She won it. She wins it. There's Sanna Thaysen. It's magic. It's unbelievable. It's Dutch. And she wins at the age of 23. Sanna Thaysen is a launching Global Champions 2 Grand Prix winner.
This feeling is, you can't even put words on it. I can't even speak at the moment. I can't breathe at the moment. But my horse is just an amazing job. And everything came out after the last fence. I was screaming like. It's almost impossible to enter these shows if you're not in a team.
And that's what makes this format so unique, that it's really like a greenhouse, a climate, an environment where talent can develop. So it's creating the stars of tomorrow already today.
Coming up, as the championship tour heads to Saint-Tropez and Hamburg, the battle intensifies. All eyes are on Jill and Sanna. Can they keep up their game?
I don't think that people see me now as a kid anymore.
Michael fights to keep the clear rounds coming for his team, and Jack is hopeful for a comeback.
There's so many youngsters with a great vibe, with a great personality, feeling privileged to ride on those teams, bringing extra energy, extra juice. It all adds to the excitement.